my name's Ali Bolden, and this is task one of my research for my regional magazine, researching the conventions of regional magazines already out there. So here's some examples of regional magazines, and at the bottom I've just popped a few ideas of what you usually get in them and what I could put in mine. So you've got general life, as you can see here on this Northern Life magazine. You've got events, you've got fashion, culture, art, food, business news, nightlife, theatre, music, local celebrities. It depends what type of magazine you do, depending on what the content will be. So what I've found is that there tends to be two types of regional magazine. Your first one seems to be quite a classical one, more about the location and more to do with rural things going on around the area the regional magazine's from, whereas the second one is more niche and not as mainstream and looks more at like culture and fashion and art and maybe music, and probably aims at a younger audience compared to the other one. So some of the generic codes and conventions of regional magazines are, obviously it has typical magazine features. It's going to have columns, it's going to have a masthead, it's going to have all those stuff like inside of it. But they are more likely to be creative and more niche because it's a smaller audience. It's either for a really small specific area, so it's going to be not as mainstream. Quite a lot of them tend to have imaginative presentation, whether it's like absolutely no cover lines, or it's really bright, or it's completely black and white. It depends on what they're actually going for. It seems to be more simplistic and clean cut. You don't tend to get as many gimmicky puffs and flashes and things you'd find on, say, like Kerrang or a teen magazine. And they most importantly have a set house style and colour scheme, so it might be completely black and white with a red font, or it might be a certain colour scheme like greens and blues. It just depends on the genre. So here I've looked at Student Mag, a regional magazine, just to analyse a couple of bits of the front cover which makes it a regional magazine. It's got a niche masthead, it's not on the top third, which is unusual for a magazine, but with it being regional it can break these ideas and stereotypes. The issue in Dateline, obviously generic magazine genre, but it does have free written on it so that you know it's a free regional small niche magazine. The main image, it's attractive, bold and different, but it is quite post photography, something you would find in normal magazines. The cell line and the main cover line, it's short, impactful and exciting. Eliza Doolittle doesn't give much away, it makes you want to read it because what is it actually about? And it's just simplistic niche presentation. There's no cover lines, it's just got the basic information that you need to recognise it's a magazine. So for a contents page, this one's really different and I really like this because instead of having like really thirded out columns that make complete sense and look ridiculous, they've gone for a black and white simplistic page number and a little bit of content. They haven't stuck it to being thirds, they've put it down the right hand side, which is quite different as we usually read from left to right. And the way they've placed the images, they've put it in the bottom left corner, like it's thrown out of position a bit, just to show that the magazine's a bit quirky and different. And for the advertisement page, it does kind of go against what we've seen so far, but it does show that it's a regional magazine because it's more exciting, it's bolder, and it's aimed specifically at something regional, Cool Digs, Cool City, where it's in Sheffield, you can see that. And for the double page spread, you can't really go wrong in terms of being completely different to a regular magazine, but as you can see here, they've stuck to the black and white theme with a tinge of colour, and just the layout isn't what you'd usually expect. It going across two pages and laid out like that is quite different, so it does make for a really good regional magazine. Ideas that we can see of media theory is obviously on your main cover. You've used a pretty female popular singer, Eliza Doolittle, dressed not really provocatively, but you've got her legs out, she looks really pretty. And this goes with Lauren Mulvey's male gaze theory, the act of depicting the world and women in the visual arts and literature, so here a magazine, in a masculine and heterosexual point of view to present women as objects of female pleasure. So by putting her on the front, it'll appeal to the heterosexual male audience. She's pretty, she's young, and she's beautiful. It's going to make them want to look at her and maybe read and buy the magazine. However, it can also be seen as the ideal self or ideal partner. The idea that another woman might look at this and think, I want to be like her, or a gay woman or a straight man may think, I want this woman to be my partner, she really appeals to me, which draws them in, draws their attention to her, making this magazine fly off the shelves because there's an attraction straight away on the front cover. And this happens throughout all magazines, all forms of media, and this is just one example.